What's up, my YouTube friends? Pretty much everyone I know who live streams uses a countdown timer. Most of the ones I've seen aren't really animated or even that interesting. So today I'm gonna show you how to create an animated live stream countdown screen like this one using free software in about 12 minutes. So let's get to it. My analytics say that 80% of the folks who watch my content are not subscribed. Am I doing something wrong? If so, definitely let me know in the comments. But if you are looking for tools, tips, and tricks that can help make you a better YouTuber or live streamer, subscribe to the channel and click that bell so you don't miss any new content. It's totally free. Today's video is sponsored by Envato Placeit. Placeit is a marketplace for all kinds of assets that can help you with your YouTube channel art and live streaming and video assets. Now my logo was done in Placeit and so was my YouTube banner. Placeit allows you to choose from thousands of designs and then you can change everything about those designs from the color palettes to the text fonts. This gives you an infinite number of possibilities to design your logos, your banners, and nearly anything else you can imagine for your channel or your live streams. So please click the link in the description and check out Envato Placeit for yourself. If you have the means, supporting the sponsors that support this channel is a great way to help me keep making content that helps you. So thanks. We're going to use DaVinci Resolve to create our timer. It's totally free and you can grab it with the link in the description. We're gonna go ahead and create a new project and we're gonna call this one Countdown, of course, and create. And here in DaVinci Resolve, we're gonna go ahead and select the editing tab. I'm gonna go up to File and I'm gonna go to Project Settings. And I just wanna make sure that this is proper. I'm gonna use 30 frames per second since that's what I stream at. You may stream at 60. If so, you wanna put it here. And everything else is good, 1920 by 1080. And click Save. Then I'm gonna right click in the clips and go to New Fusion Composition Clip. I'm gonna name this clip and then I'm gonna change the duration because I want my countdown timer to be 5 minutes. So I'm gonna put the 5 in here and I'm gonna actually make it 5 minutes and 1 second just in case so we make sure that we get the full 5 minutes. And I'm gonna click create. Then I'm gonna drag this down here into our timeline and I'm gonna go ahead and click down here to go into the Fusion tab. And it creates our media out for us. So I'll drag this all the way over to the right and then I just wanna drag this fast noise right onto here. We're gonna select that and drag it up into our left window and I'm going to adjust the contrast and the brightness. Then I'm gonna adjust the scale so we get a little bit more of it, somewhere right in there. Then I'm gonna select fast noise and click shift space. And I'm gonna type in MOS and we're gonna select mosaic blur and that adds it right onto our chain. I'm just gonna drag it up into the left window and I'm going to adjust the pixel frequency and that's pretty much it. Now I'm going to select mosaic blur, shift space, and I'm gonna type ZOO and we're gonna select zoom blur and click add. And this one's pretty easy too. I'll just drag this up here and we're gonna change our zoom amount all the way to the right to 1. Then we're going to select zoom blur and shift space and we're gonna type an EM and we're gonna select emboss and add that to the chain. We'll just go over here and adjust our power and our angle and we're not actually seeing it over here in our panel. And that's because we haven't dragged it up into our panel. So there we go, we'll drag it up and we can adjust our angle right here and adjust the power right here. So you can see it kind of sharpens it or makes it a little more blurry. And your settings are gonna be whatever your settings you want them to be. I'm gonna select emboss again and shift space and type ED and we're gonna add an edge detect in here. And now I'm gonna go ahead and I'm going to use the denoise strength, drag it up here so you can see what that looks like. And adjusting this does add a really cool effect. Now it's actually starting to look like something. You can adjust your brightness up and down as well. Add some smoothness if you like. Smooth just kind of blurs it out. Really the only piece that I mess with on this is the denoise strength. I think it looks pretty good just setting that where you want it to be. Now I'm gonna select edge detect, shift shift and space. And then I'm gonna go to color corrector and I'm just gonna drag that up into our preview window. And then I'm gonna select the color that I want everything to be. And this kind of tints up that color and you can obviously choose any color. I kind of wanted to go with this orange, but you could take yellows or greens or blues or purples or whatever color you want. Whatever looks good to you, you do what you want to do. And now I'm gonna drag down our merge node and I'm gonna drag down a background node. And the backgrounds are automatically black as you can see over here. So I'm gonna drag the output up into the yellow tab on merge. And then I'm just gonna drag the color corrector onto the merge and we'll drag that up. And now you can see our background is black. And we'll move this over to the right a little bit and we're gonna select the color corrector and shift space. And now we're going to go ahead and add a glow effect. And click add, and we can add a little bit of glow to our cool pattern. And again, you can tweak all of this to your personal liking. So yours can look completely different to mine. Trust me, if you play with these settings, you're going to get all kinds of cool effects. All right, now I'm gonna select fast noise again, and we're gonna start to animate this. So I'm gonna scroll down to the bottom, and I'm gonna change my seethe rate to 0.016. Then I'm going to move my timeline to frame one, and I'm going to select angle. I'm gonna click the red dot so we create a keyframe there. And then I'm going to change the ending angle to 6080. So that puts a keyframe there. Now when we play it, we can see it animating. And you see there's all kinds of noise and everything else in here. Don't really worry about any of that stuff. It's not going to show up in the final render. It's because I'm using a machine that kind of sucks. So I'm gonna drag blur mosaic over here to the right panel, and then I'm just gonna kind of adjust our pixel frequency so you can see how you can dramatically affect the way that this looks and all that kind of stuff. Now, I kind of like having it look the way it does, so I'm gonna pretty much leave it just like it was, but you can make some dramatic differences and changes in how this looks with color and everything else. We'll just click play, we'll see our animation. Like I said, all that fuzz is not gonna show up. So I'm gonna drag merge to our media out. We're gonna go into our editing screen and you still see the fuzz showing up. Trust me, that's not gonna show up in the final render. It's gonna be fine. And you can see when I press play, it's all mushy and blocky and it looks horrible. But it's not gonna look like that on the final output. That's just because my machine is struggling to render this. And if you get the media offline thing, that's not really anything to worry about either. Let's go ahead and add our countdown. So I'm gonna go into effects library, I'm gonna go to titles, and I'm gonna drag a text plus down here over top of our video. Drag out the length so it reaches the same length as our actual animation. Then I'm gonna go over here into custom title. I'm gonna right click and go to time code. So that puts a counter on there and we'll adjust the scale up to how large we want it. There we go. Now this is hours, minutes, seconds, and frames. So we're gonna go down here to write on and we're gonna remove the stuff that we don't want. So we don't want the frames, so we'll just remove those and the colon. And we don't want the hours and we really don't want the second minute time either. We only need 5 minutes. We're gonna go ahead and move this anchor right here so it's more centered, looking good. We're gonna go up and we're going to change our actual font, and you can load up any font that you want. Literally anything you have installed on your machine is going to be usable here. So any font that you want, you can use for your countdown timer. I'm gonna use this Go Bold one. What I'm gonna do is go ahead and go to layout, and you can use this to move it around on the screen. You can also change the rotation of your thing if you wanted to add some rotation animations and that sort of stuff. That can look really, really cool. You can also move it to the left or right, add a background color. I'm just gonna add a regular color by going back to text and selecting the color that I want. Click OK, changes the color of our text. Now, no matter what you do, you wanna make sure that you get your animations or whatever you wanna do all set up, laid out, and finished before we move on to the next step. And we can go into transform. You can rotate it in all kinds of different ways. So you can use keyframes here to create animations. You can also space your letters out more if you want using this spacing right here. But you can see our big problem is it's counting up from 0 to 5 minutes, and we don't want that. So just make sure that all of your text is set up the way you want, and then right click on the text, and we're going to go ahead and select new compound clip, and we're going to click create. And this creates a new compound clip, which makes it so that we can reverse our countdown. So then we're gonna right click on our compound clip, and we're going to select retime controls. We'll click that, and we're going to go to reverse segment. And this makes it so we are counting down. Now you can go and remove that extra second if you wanted to shorten it up a little bit. Doesn't really matter to me because, well, nobody's really gonna be there for that first second or so when you're putting your countdown timer on. So then I'm gonna go down here to the bottom right and select the little rocket ship. This is where we can output our file. And I'm gonna select the file name. We're just gonna call this one countdown. I'm gonna change the location so I know where the file is going to be saved to. And I'm going to scroll down here. QuickTime is fine. H.264 is fine. 30 frames per second. We're all good. So we just need to add it to the render queue and click render all. And this is going to render out our countdown timer. Now this is the final result. And as you can see, none of the noise ends up in the final render and all the other stuff that kind of works wonky. Well, it looks great in the final render. Now you can take this a lot farther by animating the text, among other things. And if you guys want to learn more about how to do that, definitely let me know in the comments because I'd love to show you. And if you want to know how to create a custom stinger transition using DaVinci Resolve, then check this video out. And if you're always looking for tools, tips, and tricks that can help make you a better YouTuber or live streamer, subscribe to the channel. My name is Michael Fire Jr. Thank you so much for watching. Have a great day, and I'll see you in the next one.